So when I decided to create an art piece in Manshiat Nasser, the neighborhood of the Cairo garbage collector in Egypt, I never thought this project would be the most amazing human experience that I would ever live. As an artist, I had this humanist intention of beautifying a poor and neglected neighborhood by bringing art to it and hopefully shining light on this isolated community. The first time I heard about this Christian Coptic community was in 2009. When the Egyptian authorities under the regime of Hosni Mubarak decided to slaughter 300,000 pigs using the pretext of H1N1 virus. Originally, they are pig breeders. Their pigs and other animals are fed with the organic waste that they collect on a daily basis. This event killed the livelihood. The first time I entered Manshiat Nasser, it felt like a maze. I was looking for the Saint-Simon Monastery on top of the Moqattam Mountain. So you go right, then straight, then right again, then left to reach all the way to the top. But to reach there, you must dodge between those trucks overpacked with garbage and slalom between the tuk-tuk, the fastest vehicle to move around in the neighborhood. The smell of the garbage unloaded from the truck was intense, and the noise of the traffic was loud and overbearing. Add to it the din created by those crushers in those warehouses along the way. From outside, they look chaotic, but everything is perfectly organized. The Zaraib, that's how they call themselves, which means the pig breeders, have been collecting the garbage of Cairo and sorting it in their own neighborhood for decades. They have developed one of the most efficient and highly profitable systems on a global level. Still, the place is perceived as dirty, marginalized, and segregated because of their association with the trash. So my initial idea was to create an anamorphic piece, a piece that you only see from one vantage point. I wanted to challenge myself artistically by painting over several buildings and having it only fully visible from one point on the Moqattam Mountain. The Moqattam Mountain is the pride of the community. This is where they built the Saint-Simon Monastery, a 10,000-seat cave church that they cave into the mountain itself. So the first time I stand on top of the mountain and I look at the neighborhood, I ask myself, how on earth will I convince all those owners to let me paint on their building? And then Meg came. Meg is a guide from the church. He told me the only person that I needed to convince was Father Samran, who is the leader of the community. But to convince Father Samran, I needed to convince Mario, who is a Polish artist who moved to Cairo 20 years ago and who created all the artwork of the cave church. I'm really grateful to Mario. He was the key of the project. He managed to get me a meeting with Father Samran, and surprisingly, he loved the idea. He asked me about where did I paint it before and how I would make it happen. And he was mainly concerned by what I was going to write. In every work that I create, I write messages with my style of Arabic calligraphy. I make sure that those messages are relevant to the place where I'm painting, but has this universal dimension so anybody around the world can relate to it. So for Manshiat Nasser, I decided to write in Arabic the word of Saint Athanasius of Alexandria, a Coptic bishop from the 3rd century who said, "In arada ahad an yabsar nur ash-shams fa inna alayhi an yamsa 'aynayhi," which means in English, anyone wants to see the sunlight clearly need to wipe his eyes first. It was really important for me that the community felt connected to the words. And for me, this quote was perfectly reflecting the spirit of the project. So Father Samran blessed the project, and his approval brought all the residents on board. Hundreds of liters of paint, a dozen of blue manual lifts, several trips back and forth to Cairo, a strong and solid team from France, North Africa, Middle East, and the US, and after a year of planning and logistics, there we are. My team and some members from the local community creating a piece that will spread over 50 buildings, some filling up the space of the calligraphy that I trace with color. Here's some blue, there's some yellow, there's some orange, some other, like carrying some sandbags and putting them on the top of the building to hold those manual lifts, and some other assembling and disassembling the same lift and moving them around the different building. At the beginning of the project, I numbered all those buildings on my sketch, and there was no real interaction with the community. People didn't get the point of all of this. But fast enough, those building number became family name. The first building was the house of Uncle Ibrahim. Uncle Ibrahim was such an enthusiastic person. He was always singing and making jokes. And his daughters and son saved me, actually, from his bull who wanted to attack me on the fourth floor. Actually, the bull saw me from the window and came out on the balcony. Yeah. Uncle Ibrahim was always hanging out on the balcony and talking to me while I was painting. I remember him saying that he didn't go to the mountain for 10 years and that he never takes a day off. He said that if he stopped working, who will stop the garbage? But surprisingly, at the end of the project, he came all the way to the mountain to look at the piece. He was really proud to see his house painted. And he said that this project was a project of peace and... Sorry. So he said that was a project of peace and unity that it brought people together. So his perception toward the project changed, and my perception toward the community changed also, and toward what they do. You know, all the garbage that everybody is disgusted by is not theirs. They just work out of it. Actually, they don't live in the garbage, they live from the garbage. So I start doubting myself and wondering what was the real purpose, you know, of this whole project? It was not about beautifying a place by bringing art to it. It was about switching perception, you know, and open a dialogue on the connection that we have with communities that we don't know. So day after day, the calligraphy circle was taking shape. And we were always excited to go back on the mountain to look at the piece. And standing exactly at this point every day made me realize the symbolic behind this anamorphic piece. If you want to see the real image of somebody, maybe you should change, you know, your angle. There was doubts and difficulties, like fears and stress. It wasn't simple, like, to work in such environment, sometimes having pigs under you while you paint, or climbing a stack of garbage to reach a lift. But we all got over the fear of the high, the swinging lift, the strength of the smell, and also the stress of not finishing on time. But the kindness of all those people made us forget everything. The building number 3 was the house of Uncle Bahrit and Auntie Farida. In Egyptian, they have this expression that says, Ahsan Nas, which means the best people. They were the best people. We used to take our break in front of their houses, and all the kids of the neighborhood used to join us. I was impressed and amazed, actually, by the kids of Manshiat Nasser. For the first few days, they were always refusing anything that we were offering them, either a snack or a drink. So I asked Auntie Farida, why is that? And she told me they teach their kids to refuse anything from somebody that they don't know because maybe this person needs it more than they do. So at this exact point, I realized that actually the Zareb community was the ideal context to raise the topic of perception. We need to question our level of misconception and judgment we can have, you know, as a society upon communities based on their difference. I remember how we got delayed on Uncle Ibrahim's house when his pigs that are bred on the rooftop were eating the sandbags that hold the lift. Yeah. The house of Uncle Bahrit and Auntie Farida was this kind of meeting point. Everybody used to gather there. I think this is what Uncle Ibrahim meant when he said that was the project of peace and unity, because I really felt that people were coming together. Everyone was greeting us with a smile, offering us a drink, or inviting us in their own house for lunch, you know? And sometimes you're on the first level of a building, somebody opens his window and offers you some tea, and then the same thing happens on the second floor, and you keep going all the way to the top, you know? So, I think I never drink as much tea as I did in Egypt. And to be honest with you, we could have finished earlier, but I think it took us 3 weeks because of all those tea breaks. Yeah. In Egypt, they have another expression, which is Nawartuna, which means you brought light to us. In Manshiat Nasser, they were always telling us this. The calligraphy, actually, I use the white glow-in-the-dark paint for the calligraphy. So at the end of the project, we rented some black light projectors and lit up the whole neighborhood, surprising everybody around. We wanted to tell them that they are the one who brought light to us. The Zareb community are strong, honest, hard worker, and they know their value. The people of Cairo call them the Zabbalin, which means the people of the garbage. But ironically, the people of Manshiat Nasser call the people of Cairo the Zabbalin. They say they are the one who produce the garbage, not them, you know? The goal was to leave something to this community, but I feel that they are the one who left something in our lives. You know, the art project was just a pretext for this amazing human experience. The art piece at some point will disappear or vanish, and actually there is somebody who is building a second floor in front of Uncle Ibrahim's house, so it's covered part of the painting, so I might need to go back and paint over it. It was about the experience, about the story, about the moment. From the street of the neighborhood, the painting appears in fragment, isolated from one another, standing alone, but connected with this line of calligraphy that today reveals the profound message that we should all think about before we want to judge somebody. Anyone who wants to see the sunlight clearly needs to wipe his eyes first. Thank you.